So, honorable professors and dear students, a very good afternoon to all of you. I'm Sadak Kunjum from True Facade Design. Am I audible?
Yes.
Yes, ma'am.
Yeah. So, I'm Sadak Kunjum from True Facade Design. I welcome you all to this webinar on World of Facade. We are really grateful to Jindal Global University for giving us this opportunity to introduce World of Facade to such an elite audience. It's really a great pleasure to introduce True Facade Design, a facade consultancy where True is our foundation, facade is our profession, and design is our True. We are basically a facade technical support company for providing design and engineering with an objective of being a solution provider for all the needs pertaining to facade. Here, let me mention one point to our participant students that we are not professors. We are professionals in our field, or like you may say experts, who would be introducing facade through our experiences. So let's begin the session. So before going in detail, let me first show you few images of the executed projects where we have done the facade. This will help you to have a better understanding of what facade really is. So this project, what you see here in the slide, is a Tower 11 at Gurgaon. This is a building of height 50 meters. Facade area done is 10,000 square meter. And the facade system used is unitized glazing, ACP cladding, and the glass used was of thickness 38 mm. The blue portion that you see here in the image, in all the four images, the collage of these images, is the glass facade. And the gray portion, what you see here, is the ACP cladding. Second example is the Canvas Tech Space at Noida. This project we have done along with the architects from Spain. It's a building of height 75 meters. Area done is 30,000 square meters. And the glass used in this project is one of the thickness 24 mm. Facade items used were unitized glazing and Swiss cladding. And the glazing system used was unitized glazing system. In this system, what you see over here, on the extreme corners, the gray portion that is running vertically is the glass facade, and the golden portion that you see here is the Swiss cladding, which is the unique feature of this project. Then we have this French Embassy School situated at Gurgaon. In this project, the architect is from France, and the colorful portion that you see here in the image, all the three images, these are the 3D panel of solid aluminium sheet. This particular component used is the 3D panel of solid aluminium sheet, and the total facade area done in this project is around 2500 square meter. This project is very nearby from our place, that is the Dehradun Airport. The height of the building is about 30 meters. Facade area done is 30,000 square meters. Glass used is of thickness 41 mm. And the system of facade that is used is hybrid system. I'll be discussing about all these facade systems in our coming slides. And I'm just telling the short preview of the facade systems in this slide. And I'll be covering in the coming slides the detailed thing, okay? So here, what you see, the blue glass portion is the glass facade, and the white portion, what you see, is the cladding, ACP cladding. So I hope you all might have got an idea of how facade really looks like. So in this session, I would be covering introduction of world of this facade, benefits of facade glazing, basic consideration of design, facade building material, facade systems used, method of installation, which is a very crucial part, facade maintenance, code and standards used, and the various softwares involved. So let's start with the world of facade. Building facades form a larger part of our first impression and are often taken as the face value. A building must be considered like a human being, very much alive. It must have some uniqueness, some wholeness about it. And that is where facade comes into picture. Facade gives an envelope to a naked building, beauty to a naked building made out of concrete structure or steel structure. Over here, what you see at the extreme corner is the image of the two image of the same two building. The above image is the image of the concrete, naked concrete structure. And below is the same concrete structure enveloped with facade. The blue portion, what you see over here, is the glazing, and the gray portion in the extreme corners, what you see is the ACP cladding. Facade is also substitute for brick wall or block wall. It gives an opportunity to building owner to fulfill the desires or dreams of imaginary to reality. Typically, facade is what adds architectural character and aesthetic feel to a building, thereby providing its unique personality. So you can say, in short, curtain glazing is a part of facade which basically comprises of glass and aluminium structure. So let me show a few more examples to have a better understanding. Okay. So in previous slide, what we have seen is the naked concrete structure. And this building is a naked concrete steel building. At the extreme left, what you see is the naked steel structure, and the same steel structure is being enveloped with facade on the extreme right. The behind white portion is the stone cladding, and the this over gray portion is the glazing. As already shown in previous slide, this is the Canto Tech Space Noida project. It has very unique features because, as already mentioned, the architect of this project is from Spain. Extreme rightmost is the collage of the concrete structure without facade, and the extreme right images of the same building enveloped with facade. The vertical portion on the extreme corners are the glazing, and the golden portion over here is the ACP cladding. So these are the examples with which we can get a layman can have an idea of what facade really looks like or what facade really is, because most of the people who are not technically related to this field, they don't know what facade is. It's a new terminology for them. So these examples give an idea. Moving over to the benefits of facade, why we really use facade and why it is a breakthrough in the industry, in the construction industry, because of its benefits. Like, they are very easy to install, they are hassle-free, they are easy to install, quite environmental friendly, and it saves lots of time. They are quite lightweight. Maintenance cost, as always, it's very low, which brings into picture a facade as a breakthrough, and less manpower is required for the installation of facade. Now moving on to our next slide of basic consideration of design. As we all know that there are certain consideration that needs to be considered for design any project, because design is the backbone of any project. So there are few points that needs to be considered. First one being wind pressure as per IS 875 to make structure and its components structurally safe. These points needs to be considered because wind pressure, as you know, varies from place to place. Then the next point is the environmental study for selection of material and facade system. This environmental study includes the maximum and the minimum temperature of that particular place, and it also includes the sun path, the direction in which the sun moves in the daytime, during afternoon, during evening. So environmental study includes this sun path also. Then comes the facade system. Facade system also plays a very pivotal role considering before designing any project. Facade system, high-rise building, we offer unitized glazing, and for low-rise building, we offer semi-unitized facade system. I'll be covering these two facade system in my coming slides. So facade system, for low-rise we use semi-unitized, and for high-rise we use unitized glazing system. The next point that needs to be considered is the building structure, concrete or steel. As already explained in our previous slides, that the different facade systems are used for enveloping naked concrete structure or naked steel structure. Now comes the architectural aesthetical demand. In this point, we have to design facade in such a way without compromising architectural perspective. Like, we have to go to the mind of the architecture, what he wants. As per his requirement, as per his demand, we have to design our project. Now, once the designing criteria are met, the next what needs to be considered are the important facade components. The first one being aluminium. Aluminium is used as a structural section which is connected to concrete or steel structure by means of bracket. Over here, the image, the gray portion that is used here is aluminium part. Now, the next component is glass, which is used as aesthetical or environmental element based on the environment. This portion, the blue portion over here in the same first image, is the glass component used. Now the next component is solid aluminium sheet. A solid aluminium sheet is used as a 3D aesthetical element. It is used to give 3D effect to the material. I have already shown a previous slide of French Embassy's project where you might have like seen the colorful panels. Those are nothing but a solid aluminium sheet that gives 3D effect. This image, the second on the collage, is the solid aluminium sheet. Now next element is the ACM, aluminium composite material. This image, what you see over here, is the aluminium composite material, and it is mostly used to clad solid wall or block wall. This is the ACM. Now the structural silicone. This structural silicone is used as a bonding material between glass and the aluminium. To be precise, in the image, first image, what you see here, the gray portion that is bonding the glass blue structure with the gray structure. At this point, this is what is the structural silicone that is bonding the glass and the aluminium. Now the fifth component being rock wool. This is used for thermal insulation and fire safety. This is the image of rock wool that is used for thermal insulation. Now moving on to next slide, which is very important, facade systems. Facade system, as you know, is hidden from outside, but it is quite visible from inside of the building. Generally, what we see from outside is the glass and the aluminium sheets. So there are different types of facade systems used depending on the different types of concrete or steel structure. The first one and the latest one that is being used is a structurally glazed unitized system. In this system, what happens? This system is fabricated in the factory and installed at the site. So this is a breakthrough and very latest thing that is in trend. And this image that I'm showing you here is the structurally glazed unitized system. Fabrication done in the factory, installation done at the site. Now the second system is structurally glazed semi-unitized system. So in this system, what happens? Fabrication and installation, both the processes are done at the site, then and there. They are done at the site. So I hope you are able to make the difference between the unitized system and the semi-unitized system. Unitized system, fabrication done in the factory, installation done at the site. Semi-unitized system, both the process, fabrication, installation done at the site. So now this image, the second image is it's the semi-unitized system. Now coming over to semi-unitized toggle system. Now in this system, what happens? This system is semi-fabricated in glass processing unit and then installed at the site. This image, third image, is the semi-unitized toggle system. Now the fourth system is conventional built-in wall system. This is an age-old conventional type system in which glass is mechanically installed or fixed with aluminium structure. This fourth image, what you see over here, is the conventional 13 wall system. Now moving over to the next facade system, spider glazing system. The spider glazing system, this system is fixed with SS, that is stainless steel fittings. This system has been used in the it gives a look of like a web of a spider. Fifth image, what you see over here, is a spider glazing system. Then the next facade system that is that I use are the hybrid glazing system. In hybrid glazing system, high tension and compression rods are used. This system has been used in Dehradun Airport, which is the latest one being used. And the coming over to the frameless glazing system. In this system, aluminium channels are fixed with the glass in such a way that the frames are not visible. As you can see in the image, in the last image, the frames are not at all visible. The only thing that is visible is the glass thing. So the name frameless glazing system. Moving over to our next slide, which is the most crucial, important or vital part with respect to the construction and execution of the project, which is installation methodology. Now here I'm going to play a video so to make you understand the sequence of installation. So let's begin with the video. So first we will have a look how brackets are installed to the building structure. Brackets are connected to the building beam or slab. As you can see, brackets are connected to the floor slab. These are the facade panels that are connected to the brackets. Further in the video, you'll see while there will be structural tolerance, whereas if they move left and right, how they are being taken care of, structural tolerance in the bracket.
Ma'am, I think you are muted. We can't hear you if you are saying something.
One second.
Yeah, now we can. Also, does this video have sound also in it?
Yeah. Over here, you can see the facade panels are being installed one by one and the brackets which are connected to the building structure. Now you will see how facade panels are stacked and installed at certain heights. Now over here, here you are going to see how easily and how swiftly facade envelops a naked structure, which is one of the merits of facade system. I hope now you have might have got an idea of the sequence and the way the installation can be carried out at the site. So moving over to the next slide is about the facade maintenance and inspection. Am I audible?
Yes,
yes.
Ma'am, audible.
Thank you. So facades are the skin of a building. As already mentioned, they like buildings are treated as human being. So facade becomes the skin of a building. So they are very much like the human body skin and are essential to the structural health and appearance. The building can be sleek or can be classic with stone ornaments. However, over the time, building facade can deteriorate and not only reduces the building visual appeal but becomes hazardous. So of the span of 15 to 20 years, the gasket deteriorates and it needs to be replaced, or else the glass over it may suffer a fall and it can cause tragic accidents. The taller the building, the greater the risk. If pieces or break of a building break, facade can be disastrous or deadly. These occurrences lead us to adopt facade inspection ordinances requiring building owners to maintain and restore their facade to prevent tragic accidents. Over here in the image, you can see these are the gaskets and they get deteriorated like in a span of 15 to 20 years and need to be replaced periodically. Now moving to the next content, that is the codes and standards. For designing facade, there are certain codes and standards that we need to follow. The first one is IS 875 Part 3 2015. This is used for wind pressure determination. The second code is IS 8147 Code of Practice for use of aluminium alloys in structures. The third one is IS 800-2007. This code of practice is for general use of aluminium alloys in structures. The third one is IS 800-2007. This code of practice is for general construction in steel. Then NBC 2016 Volume 1 Section 8. This is for glass and glazing. Then is the Australian Standard 2016. That is for the glass. And the last code and standard is the ASTME 1300-04. This is for the glass. Now moving to the next slide, it comprises of the soft base. As we all know, this is a technology based era, and different softwares play different roles in every aspect. So these software makes it easier to understand the system and makes the decision making process more efficient. So the first and the foremost important software that is used is AutoCAD. This is for schematic design, shop drawing and fabrication drawing. And the second one is StatPro. This is for structural analysis. The third one is the latest one, the SketchUp, for 3D modeling. Like nowadays, everyone wants 3D structure, 3D models. So this SketchUp is for the 3D modeling. Then the software that is used is Microsoft Excel. It is the like age-old method for estimation, costing, budgeting and material calculations. And the next one is the Procreate for anchor and bracket calculation. And the last software that is being used is ASTME 1300-04. This software is basically used for glass. This brings us to the end of the session. Thank you so much for being patient and showing interest. I hope you all had fruitful session. So if you have any queries related to it, please go ahead. We have a technical director, Mr. Shakib Alam. He would be clarifying your queries, if any. Thank you again. Thank you. Thanks a lot.
Thank you. Thank you so much, ma'am. I think it was quite, you know, I mean, I know that it's a huge industry and, you know, there are so many technologies and ways of sort of doing it. So, of course, we can't cover everything, but in terms of giving a very introductory exposure, I think it was a fantastic presentation. Also, you know, the visuals and the movie that you sort of showed us, told us in a very easy terms how, you know, the buildings that we see, the glazing systems, you know, that we see, how exactly they are made and what goes behind them. So, you know, we are all very indebted to you for, you know, taking your time out and showing us this. Thank you so much. Students, if you have any questions with respect to the things that have been discussed in this presentation, please go ahead. You can just raise your hand and ask your question, or you can type it in the conversation box. If you do not have any question, then we would like to begin with the discussion on the design. Okay. So, Anamika and company, can you, ma'am, you can stop sharing your screen now. Thank you. So, Anamika and company, can you just share your screen and show us, discuss your project?
Mazen, can you share the twin motion model?
I don't have it open. It'll take a little while to open.
So can you give us like 2-3 minutes?
Yeah. Anybody else who has, you know, who can sort of start this discussion? Maybe Ronak and Saksham, if you have your model open.
Sir, Ishita and like our group, we are doing the thing together. So
okay. Okay. Yeah.
Ishita.
Yep. 1 minute. Can you see my screen? So, this is on the 41st floor, and here we thought that the shading from solar radiation is required for the dining window. Here's a dining room because it is not getting it is not being protected from any structural balcony slab or anything. So we needed some facade shading equipment over here.
Yeah, Ishita, okay. What are the parameters that we are trying to focus upon?
So the parameter was to provide thermal comfort using.
So basically there are, I think, three parameters. One is heat. So to have some kind of a heat insulation, or to go with a glazing system which has, which provides some heat insulation. The second was to have to be able to withstand wind pressure. And the third was to have acoustic insulation, right? Folks, am I missing something out?
No, sir.
Anything else that we were also considering? So, Shakib sir, so these are the three important things that we were looking after. So,
okay.
And what is, Ishita, thoda ye bata do, what is this, ye jo dining wala jo space hai, or jo living wala space hai, what is the system that you have incorporated?
You're talking about sliding door?
Yep.
So for the sliding door, we went ahead with argon gas cavity double glazed door, which will have reflected glass from the outside and clear glass from the inside.
Okay.
Our other option was having it vacuum instead of argon gas cavity. We have like a vacuum air cavity. But out of both, we selected argon gas because it has lesser U value and it would be able to trap the heat inside.
And what about acoustic?
Yeah, so the argon one mein jo hai, argon one is has more acoustic properties. I think it's more acoustically insulated. So because we are having in one of the room, we are having the acoustic paneling, the person plays drums, so we are having acoustic paneling, so we thought it's a good option to go with the argon one.
No, why do you are going for acoustic actually? Is there any noise over there in 41st floor, 42nd floor?
There's a drum there in the room, so and there has to be sound insulation, as in if the person who is using the room is playing the drums, the sound does not need to go outside. So that's
okay.
Why.
So, do you have any dB value of that drum? Is it more than 45, 55? What it is actually?
As in, so.
A decibel value?
Yeah, the decibel value. Yeah.
We don't really know that honestly. Like, we'll use like a smaller set only because it's for the room.
Okay.
No, so I think there's some kind of a confusion. I think, sir, what the students are trying to say is that one of the room is actually the, you know, the boy's room, you know, the son's room basically. So he actually has some musical instruments and the idea is that the outside noise should not come at all.
For that only you need acoustic, right?
Right. Yes. Yes. So we are trying to figure out what kind of a glass would be better. Or what kind of a system would be better for that case?
Better to go with laminated glass. Outer one would be a laminated glass.
Okay.
DU is okay. DG plus laminated.
Okay. So both the outdoor outside glass in the DU will be laminated.
Yeah.
Okay.
So it will be a safe for safety also and acoustic also.
Okay. And the thickness is fine. The thickness is fine.
This is 4 plus, thickness you can, for lamination you can go for 4 plus 1.5, 2 plus 4. Then 12 mm air gap, then inside is 6 mm.
Okay. Alright.
We will have to check the dimension of glass also, for structurally we need to check this one.
So what
is the dimension of this glass?
Dimension glass panel ki. Ronak?
Dimension is the whole thing.
Panel, pura panel kitna bada hai?
Single panel.
8 minutes. The height is like 6 feet. And
no,
it is a
height is
8.8, you
asking? 8.8. So do you need the like
I'm telling the
height and width of the glass?
Yeah.
The window.
Single window. You are talking about the door actually, sliding door. It must be 1.5 into 2.4. Check from your side.
So it's roughly around 3 meter width by 2.8 meter in height, the full window size.
पूरा जो ओपनिंग साइज है स्ट्रक्चरल ओपनिंग है ना 3 meter by 2.8 meter
हाँ जी हाँ जी
Okay, I'm talking about the single panel. The panel, okay, the single panel. Yeah, so Shakib sir, you are saying that the single panel cannot exceed 1.5 by 2.4. Yeah, I'm not saying actually for this glass, actually for 24 mm, 6, 12, 6, we cannot go beyond that. Actually, if the glass size is more, we need to increase the thickness of the glass.
Okay.
Roughly 800 mm by 2.8.
800 by 2, it's fine. And what about the wind pressure? What is wind pressure at 42nd floor? Have anyone calculated over there?
No, sir.
That also needs to be considered actually.
वैसे सर इसमें कुछ थंब रूल बता दीजिए क्या थंब रूल रहेगा और क्या रहता है कितना पास्कल रहता है
इट्स अबाउट 3.5 फॉर 42 सेकंड वी आर डूइंग वन ट्रम टावर ओवर हियर इन गुड़गांव 200 बिल्डिंग एंड द विंड प्रेशर इज देयर 3.2 यू कैन से
3.12 पास्कल
नो केपीए किलो पास्कल
So how do we calculate that?
There is a code actually, IS875. Go through that, we'll be able to calculate actually. It depends on the
location. मत जाओ अभी के लिए रौनक आप इतना एक थंब रूल पकड़ लो सो अभी हमारे लिए कितना बता रहे हैं सर आप 2.1 किलो पास्कल
3.5 what is the height of the building
I think one story height is almost 3.5 yes. meters na
yeah it is like 12 feet
So 35.5 into 40 is how much? It's almost 140 meters.
You can say it's about 3 kVA.
3 kVA. Okay. और 3 kVA के लिए जो हमारा सेक्शन है जो इन्होंने डिजाइन किया है कितने का बताया तुमने 800 बाय सक्षम
जो हमारा विंडो का एक पेन है
हाँ.
वो हमारा आ रहा है 800
800 by 2800 by 0 2.8 ठीक है सो 800 by 2.8 और ये जो स्पेसिफिकेशन है जो आपने अभी बताई और इसमें मेंशन की गई है ये आपके हिसाब से ठीक है वहां पे वर्क कर जाएगी ना ठीक है एनी अदर रिकमेंडेशन
व्हाट अबाउट द सिस्टम सिस्टम इज वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट दिस इज वी हैव डिस्कस्ड ओनली द ग्लास राइट व्हाट अबाउट द स्लाइडिंग सिस्टम राइट
सक्षम रौनक फोक्स बताओ क्या सिस्टम है आपका
इट इज अ सर इट इज अ 3 चैनल एल्युमिनियम लाइक सेक्शन दैट इज बीइंग यूज्ड द एल्युमिनियम सेक्शंस ग्रेड विल बी 3 नो एल्युमिनियम सेक्शन ग्रेड आई डोंट नो बट देन इट इज अ 3 चैनल इज इट अ शो द स्लाइड वेयर द सेक्शंस आर मेंशनड
एक सेकंड आर यू एबल टू सी द स्क्रीन
या वी आर एबल टू सी दिस इज फाइन दिस इज फ्रेम ओनली बट व्हाट अबाउट द इंटरलॉक सेंसर दैट इज इंपॉर्टेंट दिस फ्रेम आर
यू टू सी दिस एलोम स्लाइडिंग
या इट
इज विजिबल या दिस इज फ्रेम We need to see that the interlock part, which comes in between. Frame will be fixed to the structure, so you don't need to check it structurally. The important part is interlock, the lock and shutter.
क्या section होना चाहिए sir locking का?
Because the height of the panel is 2.8, right? So need a good section for this one actually more depth. Because this is only actually a frames not shutter.
So what do you suggest here? What section do you suggest?
We need an interlock actually.
Okay.
More depth.
What specification?
About 100 mm.
Okay, 100 mm depth interlocking.
Yeah.
कोई कंपनी का किसी पर्टिकुलर कोई प्रोडक्ट है सर जो आप रेफर कर सकते हैं जिसको ये देख लें जो यहाँ के लिए सूटेबल हो?
यू कैन गो फॉर बोरुका, वी हैव अ सिस्टम इन बोरुका, यू कैन चेक.
ओके, बोरुका.
बोरुका इट्स इन मैसूर.
तो जस्ट व्हाट विल बी द साइज ऑफ द सेक्शन, उसकी जो डेप्थ है वो 100 होगी, विड्थ होगी
60 mm.
ओके, 60 बाय 100 का फ्रेम.
या
एंड इट वुड बी बेटर टू गो इन टू गो विद एल्युमिनियम, राइट?
या इट्स बेटर.
एंड व्हाई नॉट अदर मटेरियल्स लाइक यूपीवीसी और मे बी एसएस एंड ऑल?
Actually, UPVC doesn't have actually structurally safe for G plus, more than G plus 5.
Okay. Okay. And are there other options in stainless steel?
Stainless steel is quite expensive because the density of stainless steel is 3 times more than aluminum.
Okay.
If you can design something aluminum in 7 kg per square meter, and you can design SS in 20 kg per square meter.
Okay, so this is generally 7 kg per square meter.
Yeah, 7 to 8 kg per square
meter.
So the rate of the aluminium is currently it is going 300 rupees per kg, and the rate of the SS is 400 above.
Okay, so it's very expensive, almost 3 times.
Yeah.
Okay, and this window, its grade kya hoga? Koi grade hoga aluminium ka?
एल्युमिनियम का ग्रेड होगा 6063 P6.
6063 P6
टेम्पर्ड 6.
Yes, ठीक है, ठीक है.
And so, what do you suggest for the paraffin?
T6, Ishita, E6 PDQ.
T for tampered.
T6.
T6.
Okay.
And sir, I was asking about the paraffin wall, jo hamari railing wagera lag rahi hai. In that, which glass do you suggest?
Laminated glass, you can go for. What is the height of that railing?
1.5, 1.7 I think.
1.7 is too much. 1.7 नहीं है सेक्शन, 1.2 ये 1.2 थी शायद.
तो 1.5 तो नॉर्म्स में है.
अच्छा.
1.5 is okay, but 1.7 is the height of our gentleman actually.
Many are actually less than that.
Yeah. So you can't use railing actually. You have to use railing like that. 1.5 is okay. In most of the cases we use 1.25. So for 1.5, I would suggest 17.5 laminated glass. You can go for 1.8 mm, then 1.5 to SGP, then 8 mm.
This laminated glass.
Yeah, it's a laminated glass.
Which is 17.5 in thickness.
Yeah, 17.5.
8 mm glass layers and beech mein laminate.
1.5 mm
laminate. So, is glass mein jo dono taraf glass hota hai, it's not a toughened glass, na? It's normal float glass.
It's a toughened glass.
Achha, it's a toughened glass. Okay.
So, how do you distinguish between toughened and laminated glass?
They will sandwich. There is a processing of glass.
Okay.
They will eat each other.
So toughened is a type of glass and laminate is a sandwiched one.
No, toughened is different actually. There is a glass called anneal glass. Yeah. Kaccha glass we call them.
Yeah.
There is a glass called HS glass, heat strengthened. And there is a glass called tempered glass. This is a pakka glass bolte.
Right.
In a kya graph pakaya jata hai inko. Isliye se pakka glass bolte. right? इनसे क्या होता है, इनकी स्ट्रेस वैल्यू बढ़ जाती है. वैल्यू ऑफ अनिल ग्लास इज अबाउट कैन से 35 न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर. द वैल्यू ऑफ स्ट्रेस ग्लास इज अबाउट 75 न्यूटन पर एमएम स्क्वायर. So by tempering, we used to increase the value of stresses.
But even toughened glass, if it breaks, it will not be safe, unlike laminated glass.
Laminated, right? Is more safe actually, yeah.
Is it kind of a shattered glass? Like it breaks into small pieces?
That is tempered glass.
Okay.
And just system, the system for parapet would be SS only.
Yeah, it's laminate is a railing system. There is a SS railing system. You can go for that.
Which it's grade of SS?
That is what I was saying.
316. Okay, let's move on to the next thing then. Any other facade or glazing system things apart from this, Saksham and Ishita?
Sir, the pergola we have.
Yeah, so please show it and let's discuss that.
Sir, like I was talking about the dining window, so there is no protection from the direct solar radiations, and it is like, if I show you some critical zones, you will understand how much of direct sunlight they are receiving inside the dining room. So we required something to block the direct solar radiations.
You need some shading actually.
Sorry?
Yes, some shading element.
Yeah. So what we had suggested was having something like this.
Why do you need that vertically?
Because the window is facing towards south.
Okay.
So if we only put the roof structure, it is not helping with the vertical sun rays that are coming in. We need something vertically.
Okay.
So with this, we were able to, reduce more than 50% of the direct solar radiations that were coming in all the months.
Okay.
But what problem we faced was the companies we were trying to contact said that they don't build this, and instead we got options like these. And they also added the criteria of that it needs to be 2 meter length. And we were thinking of having 1 meter length for the system.
You can go for 1 meter, there's no issue.
So they were telling you if you want it retractable or something, then the motor takes like 1 meter takka area, so you can't have it. And that was our biggest query, what's happening there. So like in these, if you can see, we have the roofing structure, but it doesn't help with the vertical. Then we would have to go for sunscreens and these pergolas for protection from vertical sun.
If you are having requirement of verticals, we can use here. That shading we can use here vertically also.
What would you suggest, like having, is this like making the structure would be helpful, or going with the tilting aluminium louvers?
No, I think Ishita, aapka jo aapne jo bhi wo dikhaya tha na, where we have a roof and you have a retractable thing which is actually modulating, which is controllable. Yeah, this one. So the question which you should ask is that ye 2 meter wali cheez 1 meter mein kaise hogi, right?
Is it the question?
Yeah, right.
So one important question should be that if you want to customize it for 1 meter or say 1.2 meter, what is the way in which we can do it? Because the idea is to give flexible shading.
Right.
So that in winters we can completely open it and enjoy the sun, and in summers we can completely close it and block the sun. Right?
That company can customize this one. There is no issue.
So I was talking with Sky Roof. एंड स्काई रूफमैन सेड कि फॉर दिस रिट्रैक्टेबल सिस्टम तो 2 meter इज कंपल्सरी लाइक दीज वर देयर वर्ड्स एंड देन फॉर दिस वन दे सेड लाइक इट कैन कम टू 1.5 meter बट उससे बिलो दे वरंट गोइंग लाइक वुड यू सजेस्ट सम कंपनी लाइक और एनीवन हु वुड बी एबल टू गेट इट टू 1 meter
There is a company called Hunter Douglas.
Okay.
Yeah. So you can go for that.
They will be able to do that. I think also, Ishita, because your directionality and of folding, that should be, the direction should be the longer one. So the fins will not be more than 1 meter.
Right.
So because right now in this, the directionality is different. You just need to change the direction in which the fins are folding or retracting.
Right, right.
I think once you do that, the problem should get solved.
So those guys too were saying that it's not about the fin direction. Like I had this discussion, what if we do that? But they told like it's the motor thing that for the retractable one you place, which doesn't allow it to go. But I'll talk with Hunter Douglas as well. We were contacting them for the curtains and blinds anyway. So I'll ask.
Right. Okay.
But so one thing I wanted to ask was like if we have a roofing structure like this, can't a very similar retractable system be placed in the verticals? Or we have to do it sunscreens only?
No, you can go for that.
Okay, that is possible, right?
That is possible.
Okay, okay. That.
Vertical also, horizontal also you can go for.
So for that also, you would recommend Hunter Douglas or some other companies who are better at that?
So first you go for Hunter Douglas.
Okay.
All right. Because actually the thing was if we go for 2 meter, that would cover like the entire balcony. And then we can't have the vertical louvers because it will, you know, it will block the balcony. Like if you want to block in the whole stretch, you will have to retract the system first. But if we keep it 1 meter, we will have the space of walking and as well as a flexible sitting space. So this was the only facade structure that we are being installed in suctions area. We don't require one.
So your sliding door problem I think is resolved, right?
Yes.
Ishita and Saksham, Ronak, everybody in the group, yes or no?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Ishita, your pergola problem also is resolved for now. Not completely resolved, but for now you have gotten a new company.
I had a question for the pergola thing, Ishita. So for see the vertical, so we are talking about Hunter Douglas na yahan pe. So in the aluminium jo vanes hain, how will that control the wind pressure?
They will not. Matlab you're saying how will they withstand?
Yeah, withstand and also control.
They will. Unka wo hai, pura likha hua hai.
Impact of the wind pressure on that aluminium fins will not be much more. The surface area of the fins is only 100 mm or 150 mm.
Okay.
Any other questions, folks, of this group? Any other thing? Is it clear to you? Kya karna hai abhi?
Thank you, sir.
Okay. Okay. Great. Let's move on to the other groups. Akshita and Aditya.
Mazen, can you share your screen?
Yeah, so I think two questions are important to you. One is the entrance door, the big door between the living and the terrace, and the pergola and the sitting space on the terrace.
Additionally, we also had some questions that we wanted to ask about the gym.
Please go.
So the two main doors that we were looking at, which are like between the terrace and the living room and between the balcony and the living room. The thing is like because there's an overhang over there, we don't have a lot of direct solar radiation that reaches the door. which is why for us, like, one of the key things that we were trying to look at was to increase or to maximize the visible light transmittance that we were having through the door and through the glass. So we had found a product that was, and we'd spoken to them. It's by this company called Captain SA. I think they manufacture all of their products somewhere in Greece, and then they ship them to India. But then the thing is, there, and it also works with like sound insulation for up to like 47 decibels of reduction and things like that. But the only, after the discussion that just happened, the only drawback that I'm seeing is that the frame that they use is made of UPVC. So the specific grade of it is a Comalit Z UPVC frames. But if so, and Mama saying that like at that height, like it's not going to be able to stand the wind pressure, then we will have to rework that. So we'll definitely work on that. For the gym, the question that we had is, since we need to have glass walls, we haven't been able to figure out the specific details for like the glass yet, because we have like, because for outdoor construction, these have to be like load bearing also to some extent, so we're not sure like how to go about that construction.
What is the height of this?
The height, I think, is about 20, somewhere between 2500 to 2700.
Okay.
Millimeters. With Mazen, can you check once?
Yeah, just give me 1 second. The width is roughly 6,000, maybe a little bit more millimeters.
20 feet basically.
6 meter, right?
Yeah, 6 yes. meter.
6 meter, you want a single glass?
No. They don't want a single glass. They are actually trying to figure out the entire sort of basically
interface.
Yeah, the interface.
Yeah.
वो किस तरह का slide glass door होगा, किस wall लगाएं या फिर कुछ glass में ही कर लें. So they're trying to figure it out.
2.5 meter, right? So for 2.5 meter, you can go for frameless also.
Okay.
Yeah, for the doors, you can go for patch fitted doors.
Okay.
Floor spring at the bottom and pivot at the top. Won't be
pivot
any
at the top and what at the bottom?
Floor spring.
Okay.
There is a device called floor spring which can take load of glass.
Okay.
About 600 kg.
And as for like the glass, like will it just be like a single like glass thing? It doesn't have to be like glazed or anything of that sort.
No, it's a single glass, only glass.
Okay.
There would be a U channel at the bottom and U channel at the top.
Okay.
What thickness will the glass be?
11.
12.
Single glass.
Yeah, I think, and like as for, like since with the dough, we were trying to figure out like a lot of these, you know, the U factor, like the U value and things like that, like transmittance and all of that. Are those specifications that we will also have to look into for this, like specific like glass grade and things like that?
If you have a requirement, the MEP requirement is there. We should go for that.
Okay.
And what about the glazing system apart from the fixed glass that will be there?
No glazing system. I told you it's a fixed glass, right? So there will be a bottom channel and a top channel. And door will be fixed with floor spring and top pivot.
Okay.
And
so the thing is, if the glass is, if the glass does not have any kind of glazing, then as for like things like thermal insulation and heat insulation and all, there's not going to be a lot of that. So then will we have to rely entirely on like the active HVAC bit of it to kind of cool our
gym?
Actually, heat is transferred through the glazing system, because aluminum transmits the heat from outside to inside, right? If there is a glass and no aluminum, there won't be a heat transfer.
Okay.
Well, yeah, it will go for DGU. It will be a thermally broken. Yeah, please.
No, I think, Anamika, your question was not very clear. What were you trying to ask?
No, so the when it came to like the door, we were looking at all these different glazing systems to kind of help with the cooling of the inside of the house, which is also something that we would essentially have to be looking at for the gym. But if it's like a clear glass thing, like we just discussed, then it won't be glazed.
What is the meaning of glazing? Glazing is glass only, no? Glazing basically means some kind of a transparent or a translucent assembly. So glazing and glass are almost synonymous. They are not two different things.
Oh.
Yeah.
Okay, that probably had like a different
No, it's actually so glass system, glazing system. I think glazing, I don't know what is the technical difference, or if you can expand on that. But glass is the material, glazing is the system, something like that.
Glazing is the system. He is asking the system, glazing system. If there is no system, all this will restrain. Am I right, ma'am?
So I think what you need to do is that ye jo aapka gym ka pura interface hai, it should ideally be transparent. ठीक है, ताकि थोड़ा सा मतलब वो जो पूरा एम्बियंस है प्रोजेक्ट का, यू नो, शुड बी एबल टू गो विद दैट एम्बियंस. सर हैज टोल्ड यू द स्पेसिफिकेशन ऑफ द फिक्स ग्लास एज वेल एज द डोर थ्रू विच यू विल बी एंटरिंग द जिम एरिया. ठीक है, इज दैट क्लियर टू यू? एनी क्वेश्चंस इन दैट? कैन यू टेल मी व्हाट इज द साइज ऑफ द टॉप चैनल एंड द बॉटम चैनल?
It'll have to be, I don't know the specification, but like I think if we read up, like it has to be enough to like accommodate the glass thing, which is about 11 millimeters. So I think that'll probably be like an industry standard.
If you don't require AC over here, you can go for single glass 12 mm thick. So for that, you can go for 25 into 50 mm aluminium channel.
No, if you are AC going will be there. AC will be there. So I think it's better to have double glass.
Double glass. So go for 6, 12, 6, right?
Okay.
Yeah. This one you need aluminium channel of 50 into 50.
Okay.
So when you say 6, 12, 6, like what does that mean exactly?
6 mm glass, 12 mm air gap, then 6 mm.
Okay. And would this be like argon filled or like just vacuum, or is that something like we have to decide? Vacuum.
Argon gas is not safe.
Sir, what do you have to say about low E coated glass? Do you think its application will be suitable in these conditions?
So here it is not required. If your radiations is more, you can go for low E glass.
If there is too much amount of direct exposure.
Okay.
All right. Anything else, folks, about this thing?
I think we can have a discussion about the pergola.
Let's go to the pergola.
And maybe also for this railing, because this is also glass.
I think railing ka discussion jo saksham ke saath hua hai, that will remain the same, no?
Okay.
So height on the railing is same. What is the height of this railing? Is it the same 1.5 meter?
This railing is not that high. Wait, I'll check.
Let me explain. If the height is 1.5 meter, go for 17.52. If the height is up to 1.2 meter, go for 13.52 mm thick glass, right?
Okay.
Okay. Next, please.
Pergola, we wanted to check.
Tell me the length of this pergola and the width of this pergola.
Yeah, the So this length is 9.4
okay.
meters,
right.
And the other one is about 3 meters.
How much?
3 meters. For this one is about the same. It's just slightly higher than this one. So there's two, essentially there's two different pergolas kind of.
Okay. So what material do you want?
This is aluminium frame.
Want aluminium frame over here, right? So you can go for tubular sections, right? Of 100 by 200 mm. 3 mm thick.
So would MS be a better option for this?
Yeah, MS is a better option for this. If you go for MS, the dimension would be 61 into 122.
Okay. So can you repeat the MS dimensions?
Yeah, 61 into 122.
Sorry, can you repeat that?
61 into 122.
Okay.
Thickness 4.5 mm.
Mazen, this pergola is retractable, na?
Yeah, the loops on top are retractable.
Right.
I think right now on the model it's not showing, but that's supposed to be retractable.
And this is also sort of rainproof.
Yeah, when it's covered, it'll be rainproof.
Perfect. Okay. Anything else in this?
So I had a question. Masin, is there a cloth or something to cover it? And how are you covering it?
Sorry.
No, I think Saksham, it's not a cloth. The louvers themselves adjust in such a way that they cover 100%.
But this part is the login. So.
And I think there are like fabric walls that are available for the sides, which can be installed as per like the client's convenience if they want to. So like with the product that we're looking at, like it's available.
Yeah, it was like retractable and the, like automatically the screen can come up and down.
Okay, perfect. Anything else in this, folks, that you want to ask?
No, I think this about covers like our major.
Great. Let's move on to the main door then. The main door. You have not discussed that, no?
The main door
is between the terrace and the living room.
That was the one that we were, the one that I was talking about with the UPVC frame that we're going to have to rework. So.
Acha. Okay. But you can ask, no? What kind of a solution? Can you go for the same thing which Saksham now will also be doing?
Okay.
What is the size of the structural opening here?
So you're talking about the door, right?
Yeah, I'm talking about the opening right now, first of all.
Opening is about, so the door has to be ceiling height, so I guess the opening will be to the ceiling as well.
It's about 3.1 meters wide, or like about 3 meters wide. It's about like somewhere between 2.5 to 2.7 depending on where our ceiling, like where the false ceiling thing is.
Okay. And the height will be around 9 feet, so
2.7.
Yeah.
So, Shakib sir, the thing that you suggested to the other group can also be replicated here?
Yeah, you can go for sliding doors.
Yeah, so we were thinking of like a lift and slide mechanism because it also says, I think, it's slightly better, like from whatever we were able to read, it's slightly better with when it comes to like heat insulation, like it's better than like the regular sliding mechanism. So we had a lift and slide thing in mind.
So you can go for that also, lift and slide. The doors lift slightly over there and then it starts sliding on lift and slide.
Also, one other thing that, like a problem almost that we were facing when we were doing research for this the last time is that is it advisable to get all of these doors like custom made or should we like kind of look for when I say custom made, like, yeah, or should we look at like standard sized
doors? We go for customization for value engineering. Projects okay. Are bigger, of about 40 crore, 30 crore. So we go for customizations. With customization, there is a big value of value engineering, right? You can save up to 10%. So if you are doing a project of 40 crore, you can save about 4 crore.
Right. And so then when it comes to like, say if I want an aluminium frame and then I have like obviously the glass panel that comes in between, how do I make a choice? Like when it comes to like say standard products, are you kind of have an idea of like brands and stuff that are well known or like or work? So, but when it came to like frames and glass and things like that, we didn't really like have an idea or like too much of an idea over there. So how do we kind of like even navigate that?
We have given the presentations, we have shown you if there are high-rise building and continuing glazing over there, we go for unitized glazing system, right? In that, everything glazed in the factory. All aluminium frames, glass pasted on the aluminium frames, then we transport from factory to the site and hang the panels over there. So for the high-rise building, we go for unitized system. For low-rise buildings, we go for semi-detached system. This some part fabricated in the factory, and some part fabricated at the site.
But I think, sir, if we let's say if the scale of the project is very small, let's say if there is only one duplex that we are talking about, then going for customization will become very costly.
Costly, right.
So it is better to go for standardized systems. Right.
Yeah, yeah.
Standardized company systems, right. Okay. All right. Anything else, folks? Take care, clear it. Shall we move on to the next group then, the final one, Muskan?
Yes, sir. So, like, there's only two of us here right now, but I just had one question, but the others are similar to what we discussed with the other groups. So the window that we were, I had doubts about was next to the lounge area, to the right, Mazen, that one. Yeah. So this one is a full length window and it's completely open to the lounge and there's nothing to walk into. So how thick should it be? And we were thinking of
it's
going with a low E glass. Yeah, it's a fixed glass. And what's the sizes they come in?
Last sizes you're talking about. What's your size like?
This the sizes around 2900 in times 6600.
Okay. There are standard glasses. Yeah, there are standard glasses.
So that we can have one single glass over there, or should we have panes?
Tarun. Listen to him first.
Sorry.
Yes, sir. Go on.
So there are standard glasses, right? Right, 2.25 into 3.21, 2.24 into 3.66. If you want to go beyond this, there is a jumbo glasses, right? Jumbo glasses. That is expensive, but you can have it up to 6.5 meter.
Okay. So is 6.5 meters the maximum for a jumbo glass, or can it go beyond that?
You can go beyond that, but that you have to import from outside, not from India.
Okay.
So, Tharun, that is only when there is no frame in between and you want one single pane of glass.
No, that's, we haven't decided on that. Like, if we want a single glass
So the current design that you have, the model, actually shows three panes.
That's what it means.
So that means one pane is about 2.2 meters by 2.8 meters. Okay. So ask ki what kind of a glass would be suitable for this.
No, I wanted to know if there's an option to go with a single pane, then we would have a sleek look, like we can't see any obstruction in the middle. So
yeah, but what will be the cost implications of that? How
cost going to increase?
Sir?
Cost will get increased and the thickness of the glass will also increase.
Okay.
Yeah, so what will be the specification of that glass? How thick will it be?
For the single, 6 meter?
Yes.
Yeah. For the single 6 meter, if you are going for ACs, DG glasses, you need about 40 mm thick glass.
So 40, but the single pane is 40.
No, 16 plus 12.
Okay.
16 is vacuum.
Yes.
Yeah, 16 is the vacuum.
And what will be the size of the frame?
No, there is a no frame, right? You are using a single glass. You need to install this one in new channel.
Yeah, so what will be the size of the channel?
Yeah, size would be the 60 into 60.
Okay.
Yeah. All right.
Thank you.
Yeah, any other questions around that you have about this?
No, sir.
What will be the costing of this? Some tentative costing?
Some tentative costing of this glass.
The jumbo glass.
Jumbo glass. It would be about 10,000 per square meter.
10,000 per square meter. Okay. So that means almost 18,000-20,000.
Six times.
So this glass cost is 10,000. 18,000-20,000 is what?
1,80,000 something.
Ah, right. Sorry.
Yeah.
So this and this cost includes the installation and all.
Yeah, installation also.
Perfect. Okay, Tarun. What else, Tarun, do you want to discuss?
That's about it. Like, the others are somewhat similar to the other groups discussed. And
we don't have any open areas. We just have this balcony in front of the bedroom. So it's very similar. And
yes, Taha?
Yeah, I was wondering that could you give us like any idea about the installation costs? And even say if it's on the 42nd floor, like any transportation costs that a glass of that scale will require to bring it from, say, ground to 42nd. And any like thumb rules for installation costs for frames as well as glass?
Yeah, installation and installation cost is about 500 rupees you can consider for this height of building. There is another cost called
rupees. Sorry, sir, 500 rupees per square meter.
Per square meter.
This 500 includes transportation also.
No, transportation is different. There is fabrication cost. There is a this is installation cost. There is a fabrication cost also, which comes in effect in the factory, and it also costs about 500 rupees per square meter. Right? Transportation is 100 rupees. That includes electricity also.
And then no additional lifting costs for because it's in the
we have already taken into that installation cost.
Okay.
The normal cost of installation is 400 rupees. For this high-rise buildings, we need to add 100 rupees extra. We can consider 500 rupees per square meter.
Thank you.
Perfect. Perfect. Any other thing, folks? Any other questions? Any other rules, thumb rules, tricks that you want to ask? All right, sir. Then I think that will be all. Thank you very much for taking the time out and really solving a lot of our problems, which even we were not able to solve for the students. So thank you so much, and maybe we might trouble you more in the coming sort of times when we are dealing with other projects also. So we actually look forward to your support even in the future also. But thank you very much for this particular session. I hope it was a bit interesting for you also to have, you know, to discuss with students in a very realistic manner, because, you know, these kind of things generally don't happen in, you know, in design schools. So I just hope.
Yeah. Okay. Thank you, students.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
All right.